in the eye until the referee says time out or stop. You got to keep fighting.
Absolutely correct, Kenny.
And with that, Tyler Stenson is now 6-2 with the TKO. Now it's time for our next fight of the evening. He has had only 15 pro fights, but what an experienced ride so far for Justin Levins. He's fought in the UFC, the WEC, and the IFL, and he comes in here, Jeff, in need of a victory.
Yeah, when I asked him about his career, he said if he can't find a win, he's going to wind up quitting. Great with his hands, loves to keep it in the stand-up, and a very experienced and entertaining fighter.
Making his way to the cage, 29-year-old Nate James out of Oklahoma City. He has a record of 5-3, an outstanding wrestler in high school and college, but he has only been an MMA pro for just over a year.
He looks to bring this to the ground and try to get in the top position. One to look for submissions, but the other to use ground and pound. His favorite submission, a Kimura from the side position.
And we take a look at our tale of the tape. 6'1", Nate James, Justin Levins, 5'11". Slight height advantage for James, more experience in bigger fights for Levins. There's Nate James in the cage getting ready to take on Justin Levins here at the world-famous Riviera. Fireworks in the cage two continues. Here's Sonny Franco with the official introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, we move on to our first feature fight of the evening. This fighter is scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds in the IFO middleweight division. Introducing first, the fighter to my left, fighting out of the blue corner. This man specializes in ballet tudo. He stands 5'11" tall and weighed in tonight at 200 pounds with a professional record of 9 wins and 6 losses representing combat submission wrestling, fighting out of Orange County, California. Please welcome Justin the Executioner Levins. And his opponent tonight, fighting out of the corner to my right, this man specializes in wrestling and boxing. He stands 6'1" tall, weighed in tonight at 185 pounds, with a professional record of 5 wins and 3 losses. Representing USA Stars, fighting out of Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, please welcome Nate James. And when the action begins, your referee, Steve Mazzagatti.
All right, gentlemen, you know the rules. We all expect a good, clean, fair fight. You need to obey my commands and protect yourself at all times. Hook them up. Good luck.
Scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds, you look at Justin Levins. They call him the executioner because he makes quick work of his opponents. All his victories have been in the first round, all 9 wins, 7 of those by knockout.
Great power in his hands, but he's been on a bit of a roller coaster of late. After a knockout in the WEC by Scott Smith, he lost a couple more, won a couple, and then lost 3 in a row in the IFL. Said if he doesn't start winning, he's going to quit. So his back's up against the wall. Says he's dealt with his demons, he's ready to fight.
And quickly it goes to the mat. Now Nate James has a strong wrestling background at Lindenwood University in Missouri. He was a 3-time All-American. He would feel comfortable if this fight stayed on the mat, I would imagine. He's 29 years old, but not a whole lot of MMA experience. Certainly not against the kind of competition that Justin Levins has faced.
Well, he's been able to get a takedown, which was good, off of Levins' kick, but nonetheless, he is on top, and let's see what he can do with it. The classic mistake wrestlers make is they'll live in the guard rather than learn how to pass it and learn, swallow their pride, and learn a little more jiu-jitsu.
He's trying to stretch out that left arm of Levins.
Americana here. Kimura.
We'll see if this works. The 29-year-old James has been a salesman until January when he got out of the business. He is now a full-time professional fighter. He wants to see what he can do with this career.
Oh, he's got that in pretty good.
And look at him now. He is fighting a very good fighter in Justin Levens here, and he, in the moment, has Levens in trouble. Can James put this away? This would be a bit of a stunner if it ends this quickly.
Yeah, I would agree with you, and I wonder what Levens would do. We've seen him fight a bunch.
And Levens has faced some very tough competition. That 9-6 record, quite deceptive.
Well, Evan Tanner, Santiago, Chris Scott Smith, Vladimir Mashenko.
Now, there's a monster right there.
He fought him recently in the International Fight League. And right now, though, Nate James looking every bit as good as those big names, at least at this moment. He's come right out in his first 2 minutes. Doesn't matter who he's fighting, he's taking charge.
Yeah, he is. He's doing a nice job of controlling the position. But he hasn't been really moving up out of that half guard of Levens there. Levens now with an opportunity, maybe. Jeez, he just waved to somebody in the audience. See if he can turn the corner here a little bit.
Levens certainly doesn't appear to be panicky, even though twice James has failed in Kimura attempts. And now Levens going to work here on the defense, getting a little more active.
And he returns it. Now James better be careful. This is what Levens likes.
Now let's see Levens at his best, if he can get to work there.
Ground and pound is his specialty. Corner's yelling, get your arms free. So look for Justin Levens to pull his right arm out of that underhook on the ground and posture up.
Nate James has a lot of respect for Justin Levens. He said, this is the biggest fight of my career. I feel like it's Christmas and my birthday, and I'm wanting to open all the presents if I could pull the upset of Levens. And he knows he's the underdog to Levens, but he is taking the fight right to him in this one.
Now, there's a bit of a headbutt there. Levens kind of brought his head down in James's chest. Headbutts are illegal. The ref walked in, warned him about it.
Levens trying to get the hammer down. Now he tries to fly in, and James is quick on his feet as well. He caught that attempt at a kick and jumps right up. James looking pretty good here.
Yeah, he is. And there's another nice takedown.
He shoots in now, though, and Justin Levens is trying to crank something there with his left arm. James has to be careful he doesn't jump right into a guillotine choke.
Well, James is in a pretty tight hold here, but there's room.
Now watch the executioner.
If Levens could pull his right knee through, get the guard, he can really put some pressure on James. But Levens hasn't really had a chance to open up with his fists.
James is able to pop out of there, and quickly they get back on their feet. This will be interesting to see if they stand up here. James reaches out with the right. He doesn't have certainly the stand-up skills at Levens. At least that's what we would guess. Again, the great wrestling background of Nate James, who has two brothers who have been very outstanding wrestlers. One's wrestling now at the University of Oklahoma. And once again, back on the ground, and there's Levens. You know, Levens keeps looking at his corner. People wonder why he's bending his neck back. That's where his corner's located.
Exactly.
He's communicating with
him. Exactly. His corner yelled, hook it up, but he, again, it's legs are out to the side instead of putting his opponent in the guard, and that would give him the extra leverage to sit that guillotine in really tight.
Right now, more of a headlock there as he tries to now trying to get it under the chin of James. Nate James fighting well here in this first round, though, against the very tough, always dangerous Justin Levens as round one is coming to an end.
And I'll tell you what, James has negated the punching power of Levens thus far. Brilliant strategy thus far.
Nice first round for Nate James coming in here from Oklahoma. Said by far, yeah, this is the biggest fight of my life. And I hope to take advantage as you look at the 29-year-old whose brother Wayne is coaching at Oklahoma City University. His brother Jeff is a wrestler at Oklahoma U. So there's wrestlers all throughout the James family there. Let's take a look now at the action for the first round.
Yeah, he didn't even try to sprawl. He just went straight for the guillotine there and paid the price. He got put down on his back. Neither fighter really hurt. There's been no devastating blows whatsoever. No real submission attempts whatsoever. That guillotine wasn't in super tight. Justin just held onto it. Interesting, though, you're looking at Anthony Macias right there, the closest person to the camera. former UFC star, now in the corner of Nathan James. And we're talking early UFC.
About the time you were writing most of the rules for the UFC, I believe.
I believe that was before the rules were ever written for the UFC. Back then, it was just no biting, no eye gouging.
Were those on paper or stone tablets? I forget.
Paper. Moses, I'm not.
But ain't it great to be here at the Riviera? Oh, one of the last great places left on the Strip, right along with the Flamingo. You know, the desert and the sands, the dunes are gone. Mo Green, the Tatalias, they're all gone here in Vegas. But we got the Riviera and good fighting action here as we go to round two. Justin Levins against a very game Nate James. And James trying to push him against the fence, and Levins once again trying to crank something there with his left arm, trying to get under that chin.
Yeah, I would have kept my left arm in his corner. You'll keep your underhook. That would have been Justin Levins' left arm. But Nathan James doing a great job here in the clinch. Controlling position. He's got Levins up against the fence. Watch for him maybe to drop down with the legs out.
See him trying to work there and use that leverage, and he does. And another takedown here for Nate James.
And side mount now.
See what James can do on the side. Remember, early on in this fight, he tried on a couple of occasions to get a Kimura. Didn't really come close. Certainly kept Justin Levins, though, off balance a bit in that first round. Levins, though, being the pro that he is, came right back. And Levins moves this fight, standing back up, and shoves James against the fence.
Levin's best weapons are his hands, and we just aren't seeing them.
Yeah, perfect for Levins would be to move about another 15 feet out in the center of this cage.
And no contact, just straight
get a swing
from there, or get on top and bring him to bear. He was on top once, but never threw a punch.
Nate James, who has a slight height advantage. Oh, look at that. Levins tried to come straight up with that knee, and shooting right in there again is James, and look how quick James is. And once again, Levins tries to work here on some kind of guillotine. I don't know if he's able to get it under the chin or not from this angle, Jeff.
Nah, he doesn't have it.
No, mostly on the side there, and popping
exactly
his head right out is Nate James. James has been impressive.
Now, basic wrestling here. Controlling position, holding your opponent, taking what he gives, and adjusting. See if he can get some elbows working here. Again, looking for Levin's arm.
He tried it twice and was not able to pull off the submission in round one. But again, it's been a very good round here for Nate James. He's been able to keep Justin Levins out of his wheelhouse. That standing up and throwing his punches.
Or ground and pound. Either one, Levins has not seen it.
Hey, James is a pretty active fighter.
Yeah, he is. Just try to move up a little bit here, get better striking position. Another attempt on the arm.
And again, Levin's able to get out of it. And look at James trying to get a few punches in before Levins gets up. Levins a little redness there on the left side. So James, and his corner's telling Levins, let the hands go, and going for the single leg takedown and getting it is James. And James once again is the one in control of this round.
It's not spectacular action, but it is definitely winning action. For James, doing what he needs to do, staying basic. Reminds me of Clint Eastwood. The man's got to know his limitations. James is not extending himself, giving Levins any chance whatsoever.
So you're saying this would be more like Joe Kidd as opposed to the outlaw Josie Wells? Not quite as flashy, but still.